In my last videos, I mentioned how the best choice might be to eat a healthy plant-based diet with supplemental taurine, but it's possible that taking taurine, whether from bulk powder, supplements, energy drinks, or even shellfish, may only be safe in the context of a healthy plant-based diet. In the remarkable study that launched this video series, taurine supplementation of lab animals increased their lifespan and or health span. However, the impact of taurine dietary supplementation on the gut microbiome was not addressed. Oral administration of taurine results in an increase of taurine-conjugated bile acids, for example, quadrupling the percentage of taurocholic acid. That's not good, because higher levels of taurocholic acid in humans is associated with a shorter lifespan. For each standard deviation increase in a measure of taurocholate, which is just buffered taurocholic acid, the odds of achieving longevity in humans appear to decrease by almost 40%, 30% lower chance of making it to age 80. What happens is the metabolism of these taurine-conjugated bile acids by our gut microbes generates the rotten egg gas, hydrogen sulfide, which doesn't just give you smelly farts, but is a DNA-damaging compound. So hydrogen sulfide could be a significant bacterial metabolite that initiates colon cancer. And that's just the half of it. Taurocholic acid gets split into taurine and cholic acid. The taurine goes on to produce hydrogen sulfide, which is pro-inflammatory and can trigger DNA mutations. And the cholic acid gets turned into a toxic so-called secondary bile acid called deoxycholic acid, known as DCA, which also produces inflammation and can promote growing tumors. So gut microbes can metabolize the taurocholic acid into hydrogen sulfide and DCA, which are genotoxins and tumor promoters, respectively, and could intensify aging symptoms in the host. Therefore, consumption of a diet low in taurine may contribute to the reduced frequency of cancer. Taurine can promote the growth of a taurine-metabolizing bacteria, Bilophila wadsworthia, which thrive on taurine. Those bacteria take the taurine, turn it into hydrogen sulfide, which is linked to a weaker colonic mucus barrier, inflammatory bowel disease, colorectal cancer. So it's not just cancer. The increased taurocholate caused by taurine supplementation is associated with reduced lifespan in humans in the absence of any relation to risk for cardiovascular disease or for cancer. But the effects of hydrogen sulfide can be stopped. The cells that line our colon express protective enzymes that can detoxify hydrogen sulfide. How can we boost those enzymes? Butyrate boosts those detoxification enzymes, protecting our cells from the sulfide gas. Remember butyrate? That's what our good gut bugs make from fiber. So there's this struggle between the sulfide made by the bad bugs in the gut versus the butyrate made by the good bugs in our gut. Hydrogen sulfide can cause hyperproliferation, a signal of potential colon cancer development, but it can be reversed if you drip on some butyrate, like you would get naturally by just eating a high-fiber diet. That's just half the protection, though. The sulfur-containing amino acids like taurine and diets high in animal protein aren't the only factors that select for the bad bacteria that create the toxic tumor-promoting secondary bile acids. There's also the animal fat. When people are given taurine, like the half gram three times a day I suggested in my last video, there was a marked increase in the proportion of taurine-conjugated bile acids, but what we care about is how many are actually excreted into our gut. This is how it's envisioned. On an animal-based diet, not only is there more taurine, leading to a higher ratio of taurine-conjugated bile acids, but also more bile secretion owing to the higher fat consumption. High-fat diets are associated with increased taurine conjugation in humans, but not just any fat, specifically saturated fat. Consumption of a diet high in saturated fat, in this case butter fat, but not vegetable oil fat, promotes the expansion of the hydrogen sulfide-generating bad bacteria, and effects are mediated by milk fat-promoted taurine conjugation bile acids. So to counter any negative effects of excess taurine consumption, we should eat a high-fiber diet, low in saturated fat. In other words, a diet centered around whole plant foods. It reminds me of the whole vegetable nitrate strategy to boost athletic performance and slow muscle and artery aging, or slow aging period, by reducing our resting metabolic rate. As I discuss in my book, How Not to Age, the nitrate strategy may only be safe in the context of a plant-based diet. If you feed people an amine-rich diet, in other words, a single meal a day with cod, salmon, shrimp, or pollock, along with the nitrate equivalent of a half a cup of beet juice, you get a big jump in the amount of carcinogenic nitrosamines flowing through your system. You get a similar reaction combining the same amount of beet juice equivalents with poultry, chicken, or turkey breasts. The nitrates turn into nitrites, which mix with the amines and amides concentrated in animal foods to form carcinogenic nitrosamines and nitrosamides, doubling levels within a week. This explains why having omnivores drink a single bottle of beet juice can lead to a significant rise in these carcinogenic compounds flowing through their system within 24 hours. But what are the inhibitors of this reaction for cancer prevention? Vitamin C, polyphenols, and other antioxidants found in plant foods. So we can add some vitamin C to that beet juice, and there's less of a problem. Just like a healthy plant-based diet may be necessary to take safe advantage of nitrate supplementation, a healthy plant-based diet may also be necessary to take safe advantage of any potential benefits of taurine supplementation.